Ahoy! As many of you may already know, the New World December patch, the Christmas patch, has been delayed. And this was a bit of a weird announcement because there was already an announcement previously with a specific date, and then shortly afterwards they went, oh, actually guys, you're not getting the patch. They also didn't tell us when we are getting the patch or why we are not getting the patch. However, my company mate XR found a very likely reason for the delay. At least I very strongly hope that this is the reason for the delay and they're looking to fix exactly that, and by the end of this video you will probably hope the same thing. Because yes, things are broken again. Broken to the extent where you can fight a similarly skilled opponent while basically not wearing any cloth and have a reasonable chance to still win the fight. Now within our company, XR is a very known breaker of things who routinely tries to break the game in as many ways as possible, and one of the things he frequently tests are armor ratings. After the initial discoveries regarding armor ratings and how sometimes lower tier pieces can be better than higher tier pieces in regards to armor, he discovered multiple changes that were done under the hood throughout the patches that were kind of leading to different results, and he was also tracking that in the new public test realm for the upcoming patch. In case you weren't aware, in the first iteration of this very patch, the PvP damage formula was changed. The patch notes stated, adjusted the way armor mitigation was calculated to use enemy's gear score value instead of your average gear score. These changes were implemented in the first iteration of the public test realm and initially made sense. We didn't check if everything about them worked 100%, but things seemed to go in the right direction. This morning though, XR made a pretty shocking discovery that he shared with me, which was that all the armor ratings basically didn't make sense anymore. He had already tested some things, but I decided to jump in with him and test all the ratings to just make sure that we get the complete picture, and let's just say that was a very good idea because things are a mess. So thanks to XR repeatedly slapping me in the face, we now have a full spreadsheet of how exactly the mitigations work at the moment. And it's not good. It's really not good. The first thing you can see here are tests on three different armor sets. All of them are light armor. One is weighted towards elemental resistance, one is balanced between both types of resistance, and one is weighted towards physical resistance or armor. On the current patch, where gear score and armor rating itself don't matter, weighted armor is basically the most effective way to increase your mitigation against a specific type of damage, unless we're talking about gems and so on. But what you can see here is that in all three tests that we did with physical damage, the mitigation remained entirely the same. And the same thing is true for all of the tests we did with elemental damage. Every time I got hit with a physical attack, no matter how my armor was skewed, I would take 40% reduced damage. And on the elemental side of damage, the exact same thing is true, only difference here was that I had 44% mitigated, but that was because I had some extra elemental gems in my jewelry. This part already seemed very odd. Why does the weighting of the armor itself no longer have any impact on the mitigation of it? But it gets weirder. Because next, we tried the same thing with the medium armor sets that you can get on the PTR. And those had exactly 100% the same results. All of the medium armor, no matter what direction it was weighted in, always ended up with 40% mitigation excluding the gems. At this point, alarm bells should be going off. This means that you can get the damage increase and mobility increase from light armor without actually taking any extra damage over medium armor. If you get a hardy ring with that, you also get a triple roll anyways, so there's no reason under those circumstances to run medium armor at all. And if that seems stupid to you, then hold your horses because it's about to get a whole lot worse. Next, we tested heavy armor, of course. In this case, we could actually see changes in the mitigation. When taking physical damage from a great axe, the elemental weighted heavy set would still have the same 40% mitigation. The balanced set, however, would have 45.4% mitigation, and the physical weighted set would have 50% mitigation. So the total difference from an elemental weighted set to a physical weighted set was 10% extra mitigation, which is actually the same amount as we have on the current life client when you switch between a physical and elemental weighted set. On the elemental side of things, the outcome was once again very similar. Here we actually did an extra test without the gems that reduce elemental damage, and the damage difference was from 40.3% to 50.3%, so also a total of 10% difference. As you can imagine, at this point I was very confused about the outcome and the potential implications that would have for builds. Are we all gonna run light armor now? Is that the idea here? But I'll give you some time to think and guess first, because we found something that is even more ridiculous. Something that XR had already previously found was that the armor rating seems to be tied very directly to the gear score now, and not so much the individual pieces, but rather your overall gear score. So how can we break that? With the heavy physical weighted armor set, we took 770 damage and we mitigated 519 damage when hit by an elemental attack. Now, when you're completely without armor, you actually take the full damage. There's no mitigation that's happening at that point. But if you wear just one piece of armor, that will give you the full armor rating. So XR put on one piece of armor, helmet, then he hit his helmet, so basically looked like he wasn't wearing any armor at all, and then I hit him. And the damage was 773 with 515 mitigated. The very minor difference here can probably be explained by a gear score difference in the pieces that we used against each other. So just wearing this one armor piece, you can still get 40% damage mitigation. Now of course, in the process of doing that, you lose some things. You lose the attribute points from other armor pieces, and you lose the gem slots as well as potential perks on the item with potential ability effects. That doesn't make too much of a difference for a fresh level 60 player though. The gear that we had on PTR didn't provide any useful effects, I didn't use any gems, and we just went at it with me wearing full armor just with the extra attributes, and XR just wearing that one hidden armor piece. The difference in 1v1 combat was extremely low. Now it is worth noting that PTR was extremely laggy for both of us, because we're playing from the other end of the world on those servers, and we didn't exactly choose the best weapons for this type of duel, because Voidblade ghosts on PTR and Great Axe doesn't hit anything anymore at all. So, it was just for fun. But the fact that you can get away with using just one armor piece without any massive disadvantage resulting from that is pretty insane. But this isn't a test we just did for the fun of it, because there's actually a very important implication that likely stands behind that. And that is that if you use just one piece with a very high gear score, like say for example a Voidbend piece, this may artificially inflate your entire gear score for all pieces that you're not wearing to the same level, to 600 gear score, even though you might otherwise just be at 550 or something. And since gear score now makes a very significant difference for the amount of mitigation that you have, it could actually be beneficial to take armor pieces off in order to get a higher armor rating, which is very absurd. At this point, we're also going back full circle to the initial findings that we had. The playtester gear that you get on the PTR is relatively low gear score, it's around 510 to 518 for the most part. Apparently other players have been able to replicate these findings with other armor pieces with similar ratings, but what no one did on PTR was get to 600 gear score, because obviously that takes a lot longer than the PTR was up for. XR's theory is that there's basically a minimum mitigation that you will have at level 60, and that is 40%. And this happens to be what both light and medium armor reach around 500 something gear score. But once you go higher, closer to 600 gear score, it might be that medium armor actually gets higher armor ratings that lead to more mitigation above this base value, and then heavy armor gets even higher ratings and scales even higher. We can't verify this until the patch goes to live, but under the current circumstances, it seems to make a reasonable amount of sense. That could, however, further complicate other things. Because if that's the case, and the heavy armor rating especially goes up with higher gear score, you might be looking at a lot of mitigation on heavy armor. Once you reach max level, you use your Onyx gems and you use your perks from Constitution and from the Shield Tree if you're using that as well. Could be like 65%+ mitigation. You could basically be looking at the old Resilient mitigation values again. That may very well be intended, but there's no way to find out until it's there. Either way, I don't think it's a good idea to have both light and medium armor have the same amount of mitigation at around 500 gear score, and I also don't think that wearing just one piece of armor should give you the same amount of mitigation as wearing a full set. As such, I'm very much hoping that this one is on AGS things to fix list before the patch goes live, and hopefully at least one of the reasons why they're delaying this patch. If you're interested in other patch-related info things, as well as more theory crafting, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell to get notified of that. And also, please consider checking out XR's Twitch. He will likely be streaming again soon, and when he does, I'm sure he will make a lot more discoveries on stream of how to break things in New World. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope to see you for the next one soon. Duke Sloth, out.